Early theories of human and primate attachment assumed that a mechanism similar to imprinting was in operation. Harlow, in 1959, looked at young monkeys to investigate how attachment developed. In his first experiment, all the monkeys developed an attachment to the figure made from cloth, even though they were fed by the wire figure, confounding the idea that animals behave purely according to primary drives. In this experiment, he uses a wind-up toy to see how the monkeys will react.
Now, in this experiment, this is the apparatus we use.
That looks diabolical.
That's just the way the baby monkey feels about it. Flashing eyes, loud sound, moving mechanical parts. All of these things are designed to frighten a monkey. Now, here we have a peaceful, resting baby monkey. Let's find out what his reactions to his mother are when we frighten him.
All right.
And he does what any child will do in a similar situation.
He runs away.
It's more than running away. He was running to his mother, to touch her, to drive away his fear. Contact with the mother changes his entire personality. Look, now he's actually threatening the diabolical object. All right. This gives us part of the picture of the strength of infantile love.
In another experiment, Harlow was to try an early form of the strange situation procedure, in which he placed a young monkey into an unfamiliar room with some odd items. If it were left in the room on its own, it would become very agitated. But when the cloth figure was also present, the monkey would cling to it before gradually exploring the room. This experiment was to be adapted by Mary Ainsworth, who applied it to human infants. Further investigations led Harlow to identify a so-called critical period during the first 6 months of a monkey's life, during which, if there was no chance to form an attachment, it would suffer permanent social impairment. A researcher who also thought that the idea of imprinting could be applied to human infants was Dr. John Bowlby. Through a process which he called monotropy, Bowlby believed the bond a baby developed with his or her mother was qualitatively different from any other bond which they might develop with other people. This view has proved too simplistic, for as Schaefer and Emerson have discovered, human children may form multiple attachments which are of a similar nature. They found any special relationship was not due to imprinting, but lay in the way people interacted with the baby, so casting a serious doubt over the value of these animal experiments. There is a further point to be made when trying to consider Harlow's contribution. Holland and Webb state, "We have already shown that facts are not plucked out of the air, ready-made. They need to be described, a process which of course requires language." Hansen makes the fundamental point that language and fact are dependent upon each other. This leads us to the conclusion that the way in which facts are described, not surprisingly, governs our perception of the nature of that fact. Linguistic differences thus can be said to affect the reality created. If we may set aside the ethical consideration for a moment, we should also be aware of the significance of the vocabulary Harlow used to describe his experiments, and ask ourselves what we mean by words such as mother and baby, and how far these terms continue to shape our own ideas about the attachment theory.